Good morning, Scrappers. It's Muriel. I just wanted to come early this morning to the craft room and show you some more goodies I found at a different Target and show you an idea I had for gift wrapping of a box that I'm going to be gifting some holiday goodies in. So my daughter's in town. She came in yesterday for a doctor's appointment, and after the appointment was over, we kind of just went crazy. We had some returns to do at Nordstrom's. Then we made a purchase there, and we were just all in the mall at every store. And then we went to Target, which is one of her favorite stores for, you know, hair products and makeup and goodies and all that stuff. So this Target here again had their Christmas stuff out, picked over, but nonetheless it had different items than what my Target had. So I want to show those to you, but first I talked about this fabric Christmas tree card that I completed, and I found the idea through Jill Norwood on the Paper Tray Inks website. And you just cut some fabric strips and you use a straw, and you recall this is a straw that I purchased from Target recently, my other haul. And you just cut them and you tie them around the straw, and then you kind of shape them, and I'm hoping this looks like a Christmas tree. But I thought it was pretty fun. Now, I'd still have some fabric strips left, so I'll probably at least make two more. And it's just really cute. And on the Paper Tray Inc. website, lots of ladies posted their trees. So you should go over and check it out. It's really cool. I used some wooden buttons that I found in my stash. These go way back. I'll show them to you. You'll go, oh yeah, I remember those. They're from Recollection. You remember these, right? So they're kind of dark and woodsy looking. So I just put one with a string here, here, and then a pearl in the center. And then I used one of my tags that I purchased at Tuesday morning. They come in a pack like this. I was going to use them for my Lily of the Valley stamps, but they're a little too big. Excuse me. But they do look cute using another type of stamp, and I happen to have this by Hero Arts. This is a little container of different small size stamps, and there's a Happy New Year, Merry and Bright, Merry Christmas, and Joy. So those are just enough sentiments, and they really look cute on this tag, and it's already has the grommet in it, so you just need to tie it with the string, and there you go. And then I put a little gold star up top. So Jill, there it is. I like it. And I backed it with some snowflake paper. So I probably will make about two or three. I don't want those fabric strips to go to waste. So that was my tree that I finished. And now let me show you this fun Target haul. So let me show you these first, because these are going to go downstairs. But I found these, I'm going to call them Christmas tree decor. I'm sure they started with styrofoam, and then they wrapped this gingham, this burlap, all the way around, and then it's all glittered and shiny. I thought, how cute is this? So I'll be putting these on my mantle. They were only $3, and I did find two, and they're, you know, they're pretty decent looking. You know, when you get stuff like this, you really have to make sure that it's standing straight up and not all crooked. And then I found these glass jars for $3, and they are heavy, and they have that silver top, so cute. So I'm sure I can find some little whatnots to put in here. And I did pick up some more craft paper. They call it gift wrap, but it's craft paper, and it'd be great to use on packages, which really look nice. Just craft paper, some twine, and a tag. And I'm going to show you something that I did that's similar to that. They also had some candles, and I got the sugar cookies. They had several different fragrances, but this one just smelled really good. So I plan on lighting this in my room once I do my curating for Christmas. And Jill already started last night. Jill, I saw the video. I'm so excited. So I'm going to wait till next week, and I'm going to start preparing my table, and then probably by next weekend I should be ready for to show it to you. So they also had these cute little boxes, right? So this is a black one, and it's probably chalk, you know, to write on, but I'll put some stickers on. But I did find some more bakery twine. This was $1. So I got two of those, and then I found some of this tinsel, just a pack of that, and see, it's cute. It has a little handle on it, and then I found some gingham ribbon, so I got two reds, and then I died when I saw this. I love this, and this fabric. It's black and white striped ribbon. So cool. They were $1 each. Then I found this other little box, right? And they had several of these. It just depends on, you know, what you like. It's going to look good in your room. And I found these gold trims. And they are a scalloped. Some red, white polka dot washi tape. Some red and white trim. And then another one of these, which I love, the plaid. And then two of the red and white, like 1-inch ribbon. And then I got some more of these. Well, I got these cute little bows. Okay, there's 6 bows in here, red ones, so cute. And I got 2 more of these sacks, we'll call them, in the plaid. The other ones I had a red and white gingham. And I'm definitely going to be putting some, not goodies, but some scrappy stuff in here. And putting a cute tag on it. Get it ready for gift giving. I found this. This is a gift tag and twine kit. So it's got 3 different twines. Red cut out felt Christmas trees, and then black chalk tags. So I'm going to, it needs some green in there somehow. So I'm going to be working with that and see what I can change it up. I just got a pair of socks. Stretchy, cute. Figured, you know what? My daughter can wear these when she goes back tomorrow. Put those on. And then something I'd love to get, because I like to incorporate it in my gift giving. And these are the towels. Now, these are the waffle towels that they have. And this has a Christmas tree on it. And then this side has trees with writing. Very pretty. So you put those in the box and add it as more cushion for your goodies. And it's just really sweet. And then that one has a deer head. And then it has the gingham. So, really fun. I mean, Target is just full of ideas. Full of goodies to, you know, give you some ideas. So then I want to show you, I saw on Pinterest, I, you know, have a love for Pinterest, and I saw a simple box with, that was wrapped up that I thought I would try. So I pulled out my, I have this plastic case here, and it just says black and white holiday ribbon. So anything black and white gingham goes in here so that I don't have to search for it during the year. And then I have this holiday glassine paper pad that I got from Michael's last year, and it has some beautiful patterns. And you know, you want to use this when you are giving goodies, anything with butter, whatever will seep through the packaging, if it's a paper bag or a box. So I got these boxes from Stampin' Up. And I saw the idea of using the black and white ribbon with a tag and just some greenery. So I made this box. Now this will be the type of box that I give some cookies in. And it's a large size box. If you can find them smaller, I'll keep my eye open, because I would like them smaller. But this I would fill with cookies for a family of 4. And there's several families that I know that have, you know, 2 children. So if I gave a dozen or more cookies, they would fit in this box. But I just thought it was really cute and simple. This is just that black ribbon that you can get over at Hobby Lobby. I happened to find mine on clearance, right? The gingham ribbon. Something about gingham in the holidays. And I'm using a chalk tag that has a burlap back to it. And I'm sure I got these at Michael's, and I think some of them were gifted to me. And then this greenery here, I just took off of this pick. Right? So it had that greenery. And these are really cool. So look up in your pick can. I mean, there's some beautiful leaves. You can find a pine cone, some beautiful white, you know, other kind of leaves. But I thought this was really an elegant look, believe it or not. Really simple. Just make sure you secure the bottom of the box. I had to use some tape just because, you know, it's a craft box. And it's not a heavy-duty craft paper, chipboard or whatever, but just secure it so that when the cookies go in there, they won't fall through the bottom. And then just fluff your bow up and get yourself a cute tag with some greenery. Keep it simple but yet elegant. So that's my Saturday morning haul. I thank you guys for watching, if there's anyone up. And I'm just going to be hopefully today I'll be able to get to my shaker cards. That's my next project. I'm not touching nothing else until I work on my shaker cards, and once they're completed, I will absolutely show them to you, because I'm excited about making them, and I'm also excited about doing my curating for Christmas table. So until then, we'll talk again. Bye.